last few weeks, we've learned a lot about the visual arts and the performing arts, especially drama and musical theater. We'd like to share what we learned with you now, so come on in.
Musical theater combines singing, dancing, and acting, also known as spoken dialogue, all together to tell a story.
Musical theater originally came from opera.
Musicals began right here in the United States of America.
Musical theater, and is where most plays are recognized by the public,
aka famous.
Located in New York City, New York, Broadway is defined as a theatrical performance that is presented in one of the 40 distinguished Broadway theaters that seats at least 500 people or more.
Come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway, the hip hooray and ballyhoo, the lullaby of Broadway, the rumble of the subway train, the rattle of the taxis, the daffodils who entertain at Angelo's and Maxie's. When a Broadway baby says goodnight, it's early in the morning.
Many shows that have been played on Broadway have traveling companies that actually have been here to LA.
Shows like Wicked, Hairspray, and The Lion King all have performed in LA theaters such as Pantages in Hollywood, Amundsen in downtown, and Orange County Performing Arts Center in Costa Mesa.
Let's call it a day. Hey.
There are many different elements and many different people trying to put together a show. For example, it can be in Broadway, or it can be in our community. We are going to talk about those important elements right now.
First, we have the composer, the lyricist, the librettist, and the arranger.
The composer is the person who writes the music to the show. He or she is the one who writes the action notes to the songs we hear.
I write the songs that make the whole sing. I write the songs of love and special things. I write the songs.
Now, the librettist is the one who writes the words to the play. The libretto is a script the actors follow in order to tell the story or the plot of the musical.
Three little words, oh, what I'd give for that wonderful phrase. To hear those three little words.
Next is the arranger. His or her job is to arrange the music based on the needs of the performer, conductor, director, and music director.
The music that an arranger works on may either be his or her original piece or an already existing piece of music.
We're now going to play an example of how an arranger can take one piece of musical and completely change it around so that it doesn't even sound like the same song at all.
every aspect of the music piece is well put together, from the instruments to the tempo.
After the composer, the lyricist, the arranger, and the librettist have all created its musical, it's time to bring in a team of people to make this come alive. The director is the most important person to make this happen.
The director is the one who oversees the entire vision of putting together a play or musical.
He or she brings together all the different elements of the show, having them work together as a team.
From the lights, to the sets, to the costume, to the props, and even sound design, the director is in charge of overseeing all these different departments.
In addition, the director is also in charge of guiding the actors. He or she helps the actors interpret the words and tells them where they should move on stage.
Also known as blocking.
Cross down and cross left. And Savannah, I need more energy to the part.
Next, we have the choreographer. Choreographer is a person who makes up the dance steps to fit with the music.
The choreographer works very closely with the director and the entire creative team to make sure that the original vision of the piece is being brought to life through his or her dance steps.
The musical director is the person in charge of the entire performance. They make sure the actors know their music perfectly, oversee the musicians, and usually conduct the orchestra or band for the performance.
Come on,